Hello, and welcome to the Google Hangout with Mondelez International. I'm your host, David Netley. Today, we're going to be talking about our research development and quality internship programs. Research development and quality, commonly known within the business as RD&Q. So if you hear RD&Q throughout this Hangout, that's what we're referring to. We've been taking your questions over the last couple of weeks to make this as informative as possible, and we hope we can address them all to help you make your decision in applying. Over the next half an hour or so, I'll be directing your questions to two people within Mondelez International. First, we have Noel, who's one of our leaders, works a lot with our early careers intake of interns and school leavers. And we also have Claire, who's one of our scientists, who joined us permanently after completing an internship with us while she was at university. And they will introduce themselves very shortly. For those of you who are watching this live, remember that you can still tweet us your questions using our handle at MDLZ. And for those that are watching this after the broadcast on YouTube, please feel free to ask any questions in the comment box below, and we'll strive to answer those as soon as we can. So without further ado, we'll get started. So Noel, if you could introduce yourself, please.
Hi, everybody. My name is Noel Woolard. I'm a section manager in the global chocolate R&D team based here in Bourneville in Birmingham. I'm responsible for new product development for our global chocolate brands. I joined the business in 2008 and was originally a food technologist, which I did at the University of Reading.
Okay, thank you. And Claire?
Hi, everyone. I'm Claire Grant. I've been working here in Bourneville for just 6 weeks now in the global chocolate team. But previous to that, I was an intern for the coffee category in Banbury. So my role here, I'm working in the global chocolate team. So we do kind of the more far out projects for things that are going to be delivered in the next 5 years or so. So things like Marvelous Creations and Bubbly. I've been in the role for 6 weeks now, so just getting used to it at the moment.
Okay, thank you very much. As I mentioned, we're going to be going through the various questions that people have been asking, and we're going to go through these in no particular order. This is the order that we receive the questions in. But we're going to start off with this one, though, which I'm going to put towards Noel, which is, what does our RDQ department do as a whole, and what is RDQ within Mondelez International?
Yeah, okay, so RD&Q in an organization like Mondelez has a very wide remit. It really covers three main areas of activity, though. One is around growth, so it's around growing the business through things like new product development, and that's where Claire and myself are currently focused. The second area is around productivity, so that's really is getting the most efficiency we can out of our ingredients, out of our processes. And the third area is quality. So obviously, you know, we have some hugely iconic brands. Quality and the quality and safety of our brands is absolutely paramount to us. So those are the three big areas that R&D covers. Within R&D, really the sweet spot that we're looking for is to try and find the space where what the business needs and what is technically possible meet. So that really is, you know, the sweet spot, because there's lots of activity that an R&D team can do that's possible but not actually be relevant to a business like Mondelez. So that's the first thing is that you need to have a degree of business acumen. You know, this is not just, you know, building ivory towers. Within Mondelez, we have around 2,750 R&D colleagues around the globe. So it truly is a global team. You're just as likely to be working with somebody in Curitiba in Brazil or in Melbourne in Australia as you are with somebody in Birmingham. Of those people, around 700 or so are based in the UK, making the UK one of our biggest global R&D countries. And we have three R&D centres within the UK. So we have Reading, which is our more research-focused site, which is actually based on the campus at the University of Reading. That's also home to RSSL, which is our externally facing part of the business. We then have Banbury, which is our global R&D centre for chocolate. Sorry, for coffee, getting ahead of myself. And then the third place is Bourneville, which is where we are in Birmingham, which is our global R&D centre for chocolate. you can go into a whole level of detail in terms of what else we do, but really R&D is responsible for the development of new products. It's for the development maintenance of existing products. It's about developing new processes. It's about developing packaging and packaging specifications. It's creating intellectual property. So patents, the number of patents that we generate is a key measure for R&D. And it's about maintenance of systems. So it's making sure that the specifications and things like that are kept up to date.
Okay, Noel, thank you very much. And from that, we can see that RD&Q covers a very wide remit within the Mondelez International business. And so, Noel, do you think you could follow up by explaining maybe a little bit more about what internships we actually have available within RD&Q?
Sure. So we have internships at all three of the sites that I mentioned, so at Reading, Banbury, and in Bourneville. They cover a huge range of things. I mean, I think what we're looking for typically is food scientists, chemists, chemical engineers, statisticians, PAC, industrial designers. So there's a whole bunch of different skill sets that we're looking for. We're looking for people that have got, you know, analytical skills so that they understand the science, that they can then apply that to the business, so they can demonstrate some business acumen. We want people who are creative. We need you to be able to come up with creative solutions. That's not just coming up with funky new chocolate products, but it's about being able to crack really complicated scientific problems. And we want people who are decisive, so people who can look at a range of options and then decide which is the one they want to go for. Interpersonal savvy is critical for us. There's a whole bunch of different skills that we look to recruit for, if you like, but we're also looking to develop people. So there's actually a wide range of internships available within the business. What I would say is that we have a number of internships that might not be immediately obvious from the titles on the website. So if you go and have a look and you put in food science as an example, that might come up with a number of different roles, only one of which might actually be called food scientist. But it's about how you're deploying those skills. So if you've got a role, there's a role in my team, for example, which is called product solutions or product development, you're just as likely to be deploying some of those food scientist skills there as you are doing a hardcore food science job as part of the Banbury team.
Okay, thank you very much. And I suppose now we know what sort of internships are available within RD&Q, I guess it's looking now what that looks like in general. So, Claire, I was wondering if you could answer for us in terms of what does the life of an RD&Q intern look like within Mondelez International using your own experience?
Yeah, so I don't think I forgot to mention earlier that I was in my industrial placement year from studying food science and nutrition at Leeds University. So during my second year, I applied for this industrial placement. The role I applied for was the food scientist role that Noel spoke about. But there was some other roles that when I went online, I saw that my degree would be applicable for them as well. There were 16 other students in Banbury at the same time as me, four in manufacturing, and the rest across RD&Q in the process, product, packaging, and sensory roles. So because the coffee R&D site that I was at is the centre of excellence, it means the projects we covered cover worldwide regions. So within my team, I worked on product, so soluble products like Kenko, Millicano, Carte Noir, loads of well-known brands that you'll have heard of all over the world. So within my team, there were different subgroups looking at specific regions, but the project I was looking at was global research, so kind of fundamental research that was going to help all coffee brands across the world. From day one, you're really made to feel very at home, both within the team and within the site. So within Banbury, you're just treated like any other new starter with a new laptop, a new desk, and you really are just one of the team for your year there. I guess the only difference is that you're starting with 16 other people who are just as nervous as you, but also very excited. So it's quite a reassuring start to the year. I'd say 70% of your time is project-based, 20% is on training, and 10% is helping out with other projects within your team. for me, it was mostly sensory work, but other people may have been helping in facilities or may have been helping in factory trials. It just really depends what your role is. So the projects you're given are real projects. You're helping the business in a way, and the work you do is really going to help the company. This is quite daunting, but it's also really rewarding, and it's an opportunity to show what you can do. You're given a lot of responsibility from the start. But as well as this responsibility, there's a huge support network. Everyone there wants to help you and is very willing to tell you a bit about what they do. So you can have that through one-to-ones and like getting to know people a bit better. But also through doing trainings, which you're encouraged to do as much as possible. Some of these are mandatory trainings, but there's also voluntary courses you can go on and just really get as much knowledge from the company as you can. People often ask me what a day in the life of an intern looks like. That's really hard to say because it really depends where you're at in your project and the project you're working on. So for me, a lot of the work was in sensory, running sensory testing, doing the analysis, but I also had to do product trials. I had to work in the factory. I had to link up with manufacturing. So it can really be anything. You could just be doing some research at the start of your project and finding out what you really need to find out. So yeah, like I said, every day is different. But it really gives you a clear representation of how the company works.
Brilliant. Okay, thank you very much. Now, I guess moving forward from, you know, sort of what the year looks like of in an internship in RDQ, I guess it's important to answer quite a few questions that have come through in terms of the length of internships that we have. So, Noel, can you explain how long an internship in RDQ is? Is it always 1 year?
Yeah, I mean, the majority of our internships are a year long. And, you know, there's a good reason for that. Usually that's how that fits in with people's degree courses. And 12 months is a fantastic period of time to actually, you know, Claire sort of mentioned this idea of an interview. It's a year-long interview, and that works both ways. You know, that's an opportunity for us to interview you for a year, see what you're capable of, and for you to see the business, you know, to decide, is this the kind of business where I think I could really thrive? But having said that, we do offer shorter internships. They tend to be based on students' requirements. So, for example, we've run a couple of internships for around 3 months for MSc students. So there are opportunities to do shorter internships. So I think, you know, when you come to apply, you just need to make that clear so that we know where to be facing you. Typically, our internships will start, you know, at the start of the summer, so around the beginning of July, and they'll run for a year. But again, you know, for some of the shorter placements, then, you know, we can look at starting those at different times of year.
Okay. Right. Okay. Thank you very much. Okay then, and Claire, I'm going to direct this one over to you, asking, I mean, you mentioned that you started alongside many other interns. What's the actual intern community like within Mondelez International?
Yeah, so like I said, I was one of 16 interns in Banbury, and yeah, that makes starting a lot less scary because you're not alone. And a lot of people think the jump from university to working life is going to be very different. But because you've got other students with you, it makes it a lot easier. So prior to starting, they hold an introductory day where you meet the other interns, which allows you to sort out living arrangements if required and to meet people. And then it means when you actually start that there's familiar faces and people that you've met already and that you're going to get along with. So although everyone's in different teams, you're not together all the time. It's not that you run projects together, but you do have a lot of training and development sessions together, and occasionally projects overlap. So the project I was working on, I had to link up closely with the intern in packaging. So we did a lot of work together, but I know some other interns, their projects are on their own. So it really depends. There's also lots of student initiatives, like the Student Charity Committee, where we where we planned and ran events throughout the year to raise money for local charities. So things we did were cake sales, night walks, pub quizzes and sports days, things that get you together as a student community, but also allows you to meet other people in the company that aren't students and get to know them kind of on an outside work level. So that kind of helps you settle into the student lifestyles. But other things you do, if someone sees something that they want to set up for the students, then the company are very good at pushing you to get as much as you can from the year. So they really do listen to the students and they want you to learn as much as possible.
Okay, thank you very much, Claire. Now, I know that you would have had this question before, and it's one that we get through quite often. It's, why don't we have a graduate program for RD&Q?
It's an excellent question. I think one of the things that, you know, one of the things I would like to say to start with is that, you know, R&D is different and special. So there you are. That's one of the reasons why we don't have a grad program. But to be serious, you know, we think there's a real tension between getting the right balance of breadth and depth of experience in our R&D. R&D is quite different kind of function, if you like, compared to other functions like that. So we certainly believe that in the first few years of your R&D career, actually getting a really solid grounding is critical because that's your foundation that you're then going to then build upon. So everybody that joins R&D in Mondelez joins on the technical track, if you like. So there is no management track to start with in R&D, and we think that's fundamentally right because, you know, everybody, whether you go on then to become a leader of people or actually you remain as a hardcore scientist within the business, getting a really good solid technical foundation in the business is critical. I would say, you know, within that, you know, the benefits that you get from a grad type scheme are mostly delivered by the business. So you're going to get strong technical coaching and leadership coaching from your line manager and from other coaches in the business. Claire's already talked about some of the training opportunities, so there's plenty of opportunities to pick up new skills and you know, get feedback on your behaviors and how you're fitting in with the world of work. And every project offers the opportunity to work within cross-functional teams. So you get a wide variety of experiences, you get to work with a wide variety of different colleagues from different backgrounds. So with all of that, I think we kind of figured, well, actually a graduate program isn't necessarily going to add anything to what we're doing.
Perfect. Thank you very much. I think that definitely answers that question, and it is vital to understand that that is the reason that we don't offer graduate programs for research development and quality. But Noel, do you accept graduates onto the internship program, or is it exclusively for placement students?
No, we do accept graduates onto the internship program. So, I mean, again, you know, within an R&D organization like ours, we want a wide range of skill sets. So we do have people who have completed their bachelor's degrees that have done internships. We have people who are postgraduates, so those are studying for a master's, for example. So, yeah, we have got previous for taking graduates onto the R&D scheme, and as I say, it's crucial for us because we really need a good mix of skills and abilities within the team.
Okay, thank you very much. So moving on from that, I guess there are many different internships available with RD&Q, and there might be many sort of scientists out there that aren't too sure which one to apply for. Now, I guess maybe Claire, you can answer this one, is that will they get the opportunity to work on different projects to get a broader overview of the function, or is it more specialised?
Yeah, so just to note, Dave, on when you look online and you see the different roles there are, it does say which ones are relevant for your degree for food science. So although I applied for the food science internship, there was other areas that I was interested in. So, for example, the sensory and analytical roles, food science degree is relevant for them. So I could have gone down that way. And during my interview, I was asked what my areas of interest were. And this kind of allows them to assess what team you're going to fit best into and if the role that you've applied for suits you. So I wouldn't say if you were doing a food science role just to look at the food science job role. Then although you're in one team, you do get the opportunity to work with all functions. And yeah, that's project dependent, but if you have a specific interest, then you'll really be encouraged to get involved and to find out more about it. And like I said earlier, people are really willing to explain what they do and to help you develop in your year. I had no idea how many roles were available and how many roles there are in such a big organization and how they all fit together. And the year really helped me see what role I wanted to do after my year in industry. So, yeah, although you're going into one route, it's not the be-all and end-all, and you definitely do have the chance to work with other teams as well.
Right, okay. We lost a little bit of sound there, but let's move on. So in terms of the many different internships available, yes, there are lots of different ones, and you can explore other options dependent on your degree and which sort of track you want to go down. And there will be exposure to other areas that you can sort of look into during your time. But you will be applying for a specific program. So moving on from that, I guess to bring it all back together now and speak more sort of generically about the internships is, why should someone choose Mondelez International to undertake an internship within RD&Q? And Noel, can you take this one?
Yeah, sure. Just before I do that, I think, you know, what Claire's mentioned in her last answer is a crucial thing to understand. I know from my own personal experience that, you know, when I first graduated, which feels like a million years ago, but it really isn't that long ago, I was overwhelmed by the variety of roles there are in R&D. And there are so many opportunities, and I think that really until you get into a business like Mondelez, it's an absolute eye-opener. You know, the number of things you can do with a chemical engineering degree, a food science degree, a chemistry degree is quite mind-boggling. So I think that don't underestimate what an organization the size and scale of Mondelez can offer you in terms of of exposing you to those options that you're not necessarily going to see everywhere. Specifically, you know, why Mondelez? I think there's a few things. Some of them, you know, you're going to hear from everybody, but you know, here's my take. The first thing is, you know, we pay you a real salary and we want you to do real work. So I hear some horror stories of people coming along to do internships and spending a lot of their time making tea and doing photocopying. You know, there's none of that in Mondelez. You'll be working on real projects with real business relevance, with real colleagues, and you'll be held to account for the work you do. It's a very challenging and very exciting business to work in. I think Claire mentioned this right at the beginning as well. You know, you're absolutely treated as an employee from day one. You know, there is no distinction between an intern and somebody who has joined the business permanently on a permanent contract. And, you know, people quite often have to stop and, is that person intern or are they a permanent employee? In fact, the one of the finest compliments I've ever heard somebody pay to one of our interns was actually at their leaving do. They came over to me and said, I didn't realize they were an intern. I thought they were a permanent employee. So I think that gives you a measure of, you know, how people get treated as interns. You know, you're going to be working with iconic brands, you know, Cadbury Dairy Milk, Milka, Toblerone. These are the brands that you go home and you tell your family about and you feel very proud of. You know, I still do now, having even worked in chocolate for some time now. So you're going to have something that is absolutely gold dust on a CV, you know, when you start talking about working with brands like this. You know, you're working within a cross-functional team, which is going to expose you to a lot of different networking opportunities, and that's one of the things I talked to interns about on day one is that, you know, seize your opportunities and start building your technical network. You never know when you're going to call upon these people and these skills in the future. It's a great working environment. You know, it's a very egalitarian environment, I would say. You know, everybody gets listened to. There's no kind of, in terms of the hierarchy, you don't get that thing where, you know, because you're an intern, you can't have a point of view in a meeting. No, we encourage interns to really, really, you know, live into the project and have a point of view. And I suppose the other thing really is that, you know, we have a history of hiring. We have a history of hiring interns. So you know, Claire's one. We hired. We offered four opportunities to interns at the end of this summer. So, you know, we don't just talk about it. You know, we actually do use this process to give people a great internship, and we look to be picking the best of the crop at the end of that as our permanent employees to come.
Perfect. Noel, I think you read my mind, because my next question was about to be, do you often take your interns on permanently? And I think you've covered that one off already.
Yes, we do.
Perfect. So I'm going to move straight on to the next one, which are, there are three locations listed for the RDQ internships. So the three that we have are Reading, Banbury and Bourneville. Now, Noel, someone applying, do they get to choose which location that they end up in?
I definitely, you know, we want you to tell us, you know, so if you are geographically fixed and there is one of the locations that is more appealing than others, then tell us, you know. We will do everything we can to accommodate that. Having said that, I think one of the things that we value with people joining the business is flexibility and mobility. Undoubtedly, the you know, the project work will may well require you to travel, and certainly your early career is not going to be harmed by you being flexible on location. So what I would say is, you know, there's nothing stopping you saying, no, I really must have a placement in this location, only applying for one location, but it will narrow down the opportunities that you'll have in front of you. So I would say think long and hard about, you know, about that before you say, no, I am geographically fixed. The more mobile you are, the more opportunities there's going to be.
Definitely. And I think that applies for all of our early careers programs, is that, you know, the whole idea of mobility does, you know, broaden the reach in terms of what you are able to do within the business. And I suppose moving on from mobility, Claire, I'll direct this question towards you, will our interns get the opportunity to travel abroad on their internships?
Yeah, so I guess this is really project dependent, and it depends what team you're in, it depends what the company's going through at the moment. I was lucky enough to go off to the Czech Republic to carry out a trial during my year, fairly early on in my year in Banbury. And I know some of the other students went to Italy, Germany, Switzerland, Prague, a whole host of places. But like I said, it just depends on the projects you're working on. But with a multinational company like Mondelez, there is offices, factories in all across the world. So inevitably, there is times you will need to travel. But I guess even if you don't get to go abroad, there is opportunity to travel in the UK as well. So I spent time in with the analytical team in Reading. I went and spent a day with a project change manager in Uxbridge and found out a bit more about marketing. And even when I was in Banbury, I was in Bourneville for maybe four or five times during the year for various training things. So you do get to see the other sites. So traveling abroad, potentially, but traveling within the UK, definitely, you will get exposure to all the different areas.
Thank you very much. Okay, and on to our final question. So we've looked about sort of people moving, you know, within Mondelez. For our RDQ internships, do we accept applications from international students? Noel, can you take that one, please?
Yeah. Yes, we do. Obviously, it's going to be subject to entitlement to work in the UK, and that usually most degree courses, if you're studying in the UK, most degree courses will entitle you to do work related to your degree course. So on that basis, that wouldn't be an issue. I guess that, you know, in some situations it may be a bit more complicated and we may need a bit of a discussion, but, you know, we have a very diverse student population here in Bourneville, as they do in Banbury and as they do in Reading. So I suppose the short answer to the question is yes, we do.
Perfect. Okay, thank you very much. That's it for our RDQ Google Hangouts. So I'd like to thank everyone who watched today, and As I said, you can continue to tweet us your questions using @MDLZ. Alternatively, if you wish to comment on our YouTube video, we will always get back to any questions that we have for any of our early careers programs. So please utilize any channel that you feel is best for you. Someone will always get in contact with you. I'd like to thank everyone who did watch today. We appreciate your time, and hopefully we'll be seeing your applications to our RDQ internships very, very soon. So I'd like to say goodbye to Noel and goodbye to Claire, and that's goodbye from me. Thank you very much. Take care now.
Thank you.